Welcome to your show, Mapantsula Arabi. Sbuile Mthakathi. I'm your host, Zola, Mankayi, and I'm here with these guys.
Oh, you're the host?
What's up, Zola?
Wow. Have you heard? Wow. 2 weeks in a row.
I said I'm not.
Welcome. Lunga and I are back, Lou.
What's up, man?
How are you, bro?
Yeah, it's good to be back. It's good to be back.
Coach.
On lockdown.
Hey. Guys, we want to say thank you for watching the show. We had a killer show last week. Keep it up, guys. Don't forget, follow us on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. We love to see it.
Jeez, there's a kiss.
Did you want to do a show without a kiss?
Oh, boys, I want to get into the show today. We've got a jam-packed show.
Where do we start?
I think we're going to start with the bio bubble. Boys, I want to ask you. What? So,
boy, can I say that?
Yeah.
What bio bubble?
Fair point.
Good point.
So how many Springbok players got COVID now?
I think it's 12 plus now, eh?
You can, there's new ones, like a team. Against Georgia.
A full 15. That have got COVID
from day one. So since the day we left Mangau, Sazet Joburg won.
We've some gonna
Since the days of Mangau, I'm going to go back. The box have been in camp for like what, a month now?
Yeah, they've been together for 3.5 months.
Give or take a month. Yeah. So Vassel won't get in this alleged bubble.
Yeah.
And now half the team is COVID. So what's happened? Where do we think this is going wrong?
Who's fooling who?
I think you're fooling KFC because the same group was in Mangau.
Nothing happened.
Yeah.
Come to Joe.
There's nothing to do in Mangau. And then you get to the city of light.
And then we won't give up your team.
All of it. Back. You social media, because Ngobo, all these sponsors, they want to be around, but okay, we just want to have a picture. Nolan, he needs to promote the team. Surely, Uzzah's on something, Muslim.
But Zed, is that...
You break protocol, you're here by
a book. No, your phone book thing is, I really do, but I don't have a lot to stand on.
But I want to ask...
I want to ask you boys something.
Hold on, I want to ask you boys something. Is that not showing... They need to show us leadership, because the Varsity Cup boys were doing it. They were in the bio bubble in Pretoria, and yes, there was a case of it, but whatever. But now it's like, come on, guys. These are Springboks. These are professionals.
I'm trying to
They're paid to do this, boys.
I think also, again, we can't get... Because we've got the British and Irish Lions coming to South Africa. We've got all... We've got all these big names. We just won the World Cup. Sponsors. We need money to come into South Africa. Sponsors also, they need their fair share from Glen. Cookie cameras, crying, or loft us. So
different people just coming,
they have to be paid now. You have to give them airplay, airtime. But eventually, those bio bubble rules and everything
get broken.
So what you're saying is, so. The merchandising opportunities are interfering with the bubble.
Yeah, I'm trying to always...
Look, I'm not mad because look, the players got to get paid and there's a lot of things to exploit here.
Yeah.
From a branding perspective, because we've always talked about Rock Nation Watch and the opportunities the players will be afforded in the space. Mm. And now this is a once in every 12-year opportunity, right? All of these guys will probably get the chance again. Yeah. So there's money to be made. There's things to be exploited. Are you saying that that's taking precedence over the safety, quote unquote, of the players or the safety of the tour itself? Because is the tour not now in a difficult place?
Listening to Ulen Urasi, it's a good question whether we're going to get our educator from wherever to come play for the book. All we need to do now, we need to play in one place. We need to go to Cape Town, Sichale Sonke.
Would it have not been better if we're talking about player opportunities, right? Would it have not made more sense for the tour to happen in the UK? Players don't get their money.
I'm trying to play land.
The players don't exploit their opportunities.
I'm trying to go
there's fans in the stands. How many South Africans live in the UK?
There's a lot.
We could have sold out every stadium, right?
Yeah. Only problem is the conditions though.
It's summer there.
It's summer there. We could have.
It's summer there. Remember.
I hear.
It's summer there.
Because it's winter for us.
Yeah,
now.
And it's sunshine. You're watching the game that they're playing. They played the USA.
It's
last
different.
Week, Canada.
It's also ideal weather.
Must be fair though. Must be fair because when they made the call to come to South Africa, everybody was on lockdown. It was before we knew.
Everybody got vaccinated.
It doesn't look like it. Because someone
they got vaccinated just now. And what are the management team in the Lions got?
Just
COVID.
Got COVID now.
So I don't think the vaccine precludes you from contracting COVID. It's just a precaution. But all I'm saying, Zola, is the decision was made for the tour to continue.
Mm.
Would it have not been more prudent for them to go to the UK?
Because clearly,
we can't stay in the hotel. We can't stay in this alleged bubble. Slulu ain't known as a varsity cap. Kids.
Who's more prone to do dumb stuff?
Varsity
the kids
boys.
Or the guys getting paid?
Varsity cap boys.
The guys getting paid have things to protect.
Mm.
The kids are going, ah, man, it's just lockdown. I'm supposed to be. These are professionals. Like, what excuse are we going to make? Like, these are professionals.
I'm with you on this one.
These are professionals.
Only now.
Oh, you agree with him?
I'm agreeing with you now because Nyango never but yeah.
Get paid. You can pay me any amount of money to sit in the hotel room.
At this one, that's my team.
We don't. Did we not read this morning that what's his name? Uluzo no Lentona Yasi Sharks.
I think it's too soon for Fez, but I'm happy for him. Don't you think we're setting up these kids like worst case scenario, Fez has to go into the field in his first test against the British and Irish Lions.
But you know what's nice.
He still has a problem with his lineups.
But you know what's nice about it?
Jeez, talk about
pressure.
Fez has already played two games against him.
No, he didn't.
He played the other game. Yeah, but
his lineup is trash, but we can work on that. But let's be serious about this. You can pay me to sit in a hotel room. All you paying me to do is sit in a hotel room and then go to practice. Can I call Allen Iverson? We're talking about practice.
Yes, if I pay you a salary, Leo, but if we're man, we're a shadow hotel, you do it. I'm trying to not just like a million in up. So Boomer, you find something to go do.
No, hold on. But look, Zola, where are you going to go because everything's closed?
I'm so tired in the picture. Yeah, Hatfield. Standing in the park.
Nobody. Four
peas.
I just, one, should the tour continue? And two, where does this lead us to in August? What happens in August? Meleseli?
Yeah, it looks like
and go and defend our
rugby championship.
Yeah.
Well, it's not ours anymore because
So
what's gonna happen? What's gonna happen? Are we saying this tour should run? I think the tour should have happened in the UK, that's my personal opinion. But should the tour happen?
Yeah.
And if the tour happens, are we saying with half a squad, are we prepared to just write this one off and prepare for rugby championship?
No. You see, the thing is,
I think we can't write it off though.
Because you can't write off a once in a tournament opportunity, right?
We're the world champions, 2019, world champions.
We're still number one in the world.
Okochietu gets...
Okay, which one?
He gets COVID. Nobody worries because he has Okochietu.
But you know why?
It's just a mess, man.
There's a real coach.
Let's get Zandy Lee. Who's the real coach?
There's a real coach there. Who was a water boy?
Gents. Nienaber was also a water boy during the World Cup. We won the World Cup. Nam, you're a coach, but it's just a mess. The players also.
Tell the boys. Had Rassie gotten COVID in Japan,
we would have been stressing out.
We would have been fine with the water point.
No.
We would have been fine with the water point.
Zola,
my close is bad, but let me try this out. Attending and funding.
But also,
who's the coach?
It's Jacques.
Never.
So, but if
play.
I'll tell you this.
Why you say Jacques is the coach?
I'll tell you this.
When
no
one is.
I'll tell you this. If Ulen Erasmus got COVID now, I'll be worried, but I wouldn't be that worried. Because this is the system yesterday. It must happen to good players. If Usia gets sick, there must be a replacement for Usia. I'm not worried. I'm still saying we're going to beat them 3-0.
The thing is with Usia, there's so many other sixes who
are loose forward in this country.
My issue here is
Rassie still the
coach of the box? And my answer is yes. My answer is yes. Rassie is still the captain.
So are you saying that Rassie is actually the director of rugby?
No, he's the coach.
He is.
And he's not the coach.
He's not the coach.
Guys, in world rugby, I've never seen a director of rugby being
I've never seen a director of rugby on the sideline.
Jacques is calling the shots. He's the coach. However, there's a few decisions that Joyce would say. Like,
a few decisions.
A lot of the decisions are over.
Like 46 decisions.
You'd be surprised, guys, that in 2019 World Cup, maybe most of the things that we did is actually...
Defense was shocked, let's be honest.
Bro, you know, why's chasing this side? Defense was shocked.
James, actually, do your job.
Rassie is the coach, guys.
You asked me a very good question. If Rassie was... Someone asked that.
I wouldn't be worried.
If Rassie was sick in 2019, would we be worried?
He was sick already.
We'd be very worried.
Yeah, but he got on the plane.
But now, Ujak is sick. No one is worried. You know what? Ujak is not really the coach. He's the assistant coach.
I'm really not worried. I think they've got a good system working for them. Whether I'm the coach or... nothing changes. Nothing changes.
Because you found a way to just you
nothing changes. Which is exactly what's happening. This is how they picked the Springbok squad.
Really?
Yeah.
We picked the squad.
All of them. They picked the squad.
Who picks the squad? It's the system.
It's the system.
Can I ask you something? You remember when the boss were picked? Who did they interview?
Interview you how?
On the TV for the Springboks.
Squad selection.
Hey man, my memory. I had COVID then. I just can't remember.
Okay, it was
Rassie announced
the squad, not Jacques.
And Jacques was perfectly announced the squad.
Well, and they asked Rassie, what are your plans for him? And then Rassie said, listen, I brought in a coach from the UK. Who's South African. I brought in, not Jacques.
Lee. Yes, he's the director of rugby.
How's he so involved? Jacques could have said to Rassie, I brought in this coach for the box.
So let me get this.
You're running the show, yeah.
Rassie's running the show.
Our executive producer runs the show.
So he decides who says.
He decides who we chop and change it. You know, we just.
He can get us fired anytime.
He can get us fired. But the system is working. It's not the system. It's the system.
It's the system.
Let's be honest, to be fair, with the squad they choose.
Yeah.
He stole this guy, Cheslin. They've got Roscoe Speckman. Apple to apple. He gets injured.
Same skill set.
And those logs, Wokundu can replace. I don't care whether
Arche can replace.
Etzebeth, he's got a rib that's broken. Arche is still going through that Michael Jackson phase.
When it comes to the squad.
Yeah.
I had to piece out. The system is fine.
Thank you.
Yeah, what's the system works. We are speaking about management. The players are fine. I agree with you 1,000%. I can be wishy-washy on that one. I haven't gone the other way. I'm saying the squad is fine in terms of depth and how the squad is assembled and like-for-like replacements. I agree with you.
So 100%. My point, Nalunga, while we're there, I was just like, as much as you didn't get worried when Jacques was there. So the show will continue.
Because the man in charge is still healthy.
Yes, we'll still play after.
Jacques is the
after the games,
Jacques ain't him.
I actually want to amalgamate this point of yours that you guys are on. Sorry for touching you there.
So Roger's not here to explain this.
I know. And it's on a Sunday. Yeah. So Chance,
the Lord's
I've been seeing a lot of stuff with regards to the box, and we touched on this to say that is the money overweighing the health and whatnot? How much do you guys think the box are going to benefit in terms of sponsorship? And there's a lot of freebies going around. My boy Mone just got an Xbox.
I want to let you guys in on a sick. We almost gave Tina as a dealership, almost gave a car for wherever you was. As a Tibana Knight, as a Tati T-Cross,
I agree that there's lots of opportunities from a digital space, especially in the lockdown vibes. Social media opportunities exist, there's lots of them.
Yeah,
I think there's lots of money to be made, and the determining factor here is going to be who you are in that squad. Eh?
Mm.
Certain people are going to have more opportunities than others.
Yeah.
But to add to what Zola is saying is everybody in that squad has an opportunity to make coin.
Everyone's going to get paid. Eh?
Everyone has an opportunity to make coin outside just standard contracts and all of that.
Because of the...
So because
do
you think they would have made double the money if they went to Europe?
Probably. Because you must remember the crux of what we're talking to here is the fact that in this day and age, everything is basically on a platform that doesn't need physical interaction.
Mm. True.
So whether they're here, whether they're in the UK, they stand to make the money. They got to the UK, they probably would have had a few opportunities in terms of that exchange rate was good to kick in.
They're going to make millions.
Because if you're going to do an ad with somebody.
I'm really happy for them.
I think they would have made more money had we had fans and stands, but you know what? That's something we can't get a fool.
It is what it is, because we can't control that because of COVID at the moment.
I would have won a trip.
Mapantsula.
Somewhere.
To Europe. To watch the boat. We can't cry over spilt milk, though, boys. We can't cry. So since we're talking this money, how much you guys think our captain makes here?
Plenty.
What's plenty? Are we talking thousands? Are we talking millions?
What do they call it? He landed it.
And you're like,
Stawo.
So if they hit, you know, it's Stawo. They hit here, they hit you on umbrage.
That's why in an LG ad, actually.
Yeah,
for aircon and stuff like
Price,
that.
Mr. Price, Xbox, Adidas.
Do you know she goes to like award ceremonies without Usi Yamanji? Like, she's a brand ambassador for LG. We got an LG. Rachel, thank you for that. Huh?
Yeah, gala.
Okay, so the question was how much money has CIA made? And
guys, I think I really think it's in the higher millions. Plus
20. I think the answer to the question is he's made a shitload of money from the World Cup till now, and this series is going to give me more money.
When he does the series.
But imagine when we win the series, how much coin is he going to get? You must think 2019 World Cup, 2021 British and Irish Lions.
But that's what I'm saying.
2023, we're in.
That's what I'm saying. The legend of Sia's back pocket started with him lifting that World Cup.
Yeah, that's true. So he said his life would change, literally.
So from... Even with 2020 being what it was, the boy still made bank.
He was coining it.
The boy still made bank. And now 2021 is all about the British and Irish Lions series. And after that, you've got to go down under and defend the championship. And what happens? When is the next World Cup?
2023, it's in France.
He'll be what? 21?
Yeah, he can still be a captain. Yeah.
There's going to be a book out later on.
Autobiography.
A movie out.
Oh, guys, there's actually a documentary series from Rock Nations. And Jay-Z is going to do the music and stuff like that. It's not this year, I think next year. But I heard. It's in the. Kasi.
Yeah.
Sia, you know. I respect your hustle, boy.
Did you want to break protocol and come through and just sit to have a job back?
You know what I'm saying? Oh, Tata Nat. See, we want to chat with you, man. I want to chat about that picture.
We'll do social
skulk 2006, man.
Yeah, well, the situation I see,
yeah.
What makes it so nice, even the next person around him So if we can't get, like, oh, the pie is big. So the next, if you can't get hold of he kept it,
yeah.
Give it to the next best guy. And with that, a chap, they're getting money. And I don't know if you picked up, but Usia didn't take any of those overseas offers.
Yeah, he didn't.
He's only focused with Team Yake and Springboks.
Yeah.
So he doesn't have to go to Japan for 3 months to make bank.
He's making bank here.
Yeah, and then he doesn't have to play taking extra games.
So hasn't that changed like the professionalism in rugby though?
Yes, that's what.
So you're saying that we can use CA as the blueprint in terms of how players market themselves without having to go overseas and literally create a brand and have enough equity as an individual to say, I don't need Japan for 3 months.
Yeah.
I don't need to leave here at 29 to go to France just to get paid.
I can play
for the Stormers,
mm-hmm.
and I can play for the Sharks, and that literally from a wear and tear body-wise perspective be all you need, because you're a big enough brand to market yourself 10 different ways and still make money.
Dude, no sign of paper or... You've never heard any stories about Seabokta wins in London. So it's different now from if it's like look, shit. I'm not gonna go back to that, but Dr. Kumala wins in London. But I just saw Dr. Kumala driving a nice car.
Yeah.
Now I'm a soccer player thinking, but one day we'll make it big.
Yeah.
We've got role models. We do stand at six thinking, but Jesus.
Sia,
and it's so easy, it's not even 30.
I mean, yeah.
What you've got to respect about Sia is like the fact that whoever he's surrounding himself with that's giving him that professional advice, it's doing a great job, because in the social media age, it's this easy to mess up.
True.
Right?
Do
and
one he, mistake
and lose everything.
Yeah.
So
it was very tricky also again during the Black Lives Matter, because everybody was like, but he did.
He balanced it well. Even his wife actually came to him.
Yes,
he's talking from his point across.
Yes, and yes, everybody.
It was touch and go.
He was touching.
So is that better for SA Rugby?
It's much better.
In terms of player retention, that's a big thing for us, right? Because we use the kids.
You don't lose a bit of Steph the toy to a Leinster Tigers or something. You keep him here. You give him the money here.
Buy him a farm.
Buy him
30 farms.
And he's got a sponsor here, Land Rover, as everyone else does.
He's sitting here.
I think for me, for player retention.
13 games less, we can have him until the next World Cup.
Now, how do you get a Cheslin back here?
A Cheslin back? We need a...
Yes, that's a good question.
You can only
cut him. Because I'm just thinking...
Well...
The best player in the world...
If he has to come to the Sharks, I would be
upset. Oh, yeah, fuck, man.
If he absolutely has to come to the Sharks, I'm not
going
to...
I think there's only two teams.
He can't go back.
There's only two teams.
He can't go back to Victoria.
He's never been to Victoria.
There's only two teams that I can afford him. Sharks and Bulls.
Give me the brand.
No, not you guys.
There's money in the kid. I think there's enough money to go around in the kid.
Yeah.
I think that was a good question.
No, but you must remember, because what Zoya and I are saying is in terms of brand equity.
Yeah.
Cheslin is a name, right?
Yeah.
And when the fans come back into the stands.
Yeah.
Even if Western Province throw all the money at Cheslin, he's gonna put bums in seats.
No, no doubt. I did not disagree with you, but I only think there's two teams in South Africa that
Western Province
can
afford it.
Never.
It's gonna be that NFL thing where there's two guys in the team that get paid,
mm-hmm.
and everyone mm-hmm. else just play. I'm sorry. Like,
check what's happening in Barcelona. You.
Anyway, okay, we're regressive boys. Yeah.
But I think Sia has a lovely blueprint for how players can, as opposed to having to look to a life after rugby,
yeah.
they can maximize their potential
while they're playing. Yeah,
while they're at the peak of their powers. Because a lot of the guys play, and when they start dipping, then they go to France because they're still Zola Mankayi.
Yeah.
They're playing on reputation alone, and they're
literally just going there for the paycheck.
True.
So the guys can stay. Like, I want to see, I think the generation after Sia is probably going to be where guys can spend their whole careers here.
We can special, for example.
Yeah, let's spend their whole careers.
He might spend his whole career in charge.
He'll never need to go overseas just for the check.
I like that for rugby.
Dilly ding, dilly dong. Europe, my friend.
Just sticking on the British and Irish lines, how was that game yesterday? I know there were two games that they played versus the Sharks, but yesterday's game.
Can we commit my team for showing up twice in 3 days?
You're right. The team I watched yesterday, we were rooting for.
I would like to get those guys who are actually doing that whole bubble with Sharks. to get promoted. Hey, you're not going.
The first team, there's something going on there, right? They're the hot.
And they were there, like, they said, come, we'll play again.
I think we're talking about their age. And most of the guys I saw there, 22, 22, 21, 20.
I think Werner Kopp. The stat I read was the British and Irish Lions had 648 test caps in their starting 15. The Sharks team.
Combined age
is 300 something.
Yeah. That should tell you something about the team.
But no, he was 30, and between him and Lionel Cronier, the oldest guy.
Yeah, Werner Kock as well.
Yeah, the oldest guys in the team. So look, kudos to my team for showing up.
Yeah.
I mean, it can't be easy to play.
Yesterday,
it can't be easy to play a game and know things are done and you're getting ready to go back to Durban and they're like, yo, listen, just hang around.
Yeah.
Let's go to Loftus and, you know, play again.
Yes, but Lunga, you know they were in the fight.
But wait, before we get to the serious stuff, what the hell was going on with Wayne Barnes?
He was breathing heavy, yeah?
Well, the man was dying in the first half. I've never heard people huffing and puffing like that. Dude, like, my wife came out the room and she's like, what are you watching?
Can I be honest though, I'm sitting there trying to watch this game.
No,
but he was the difference though between the three games.
All I'm saying is the standard of
appreciation. Our South African refs
are very biased.
Blew us out of the game.
They're very biased towards the British and Irish. Yeah. I don't know.
He was so fair yesterday.
No, he wasn't. He was better than
Yakupe.
He was better than Yakupe on Wednesday.
He was better than
Yakupe. Don't sit there and say he was fair, because he blew some very interesting decisions. I'm sorry.
But he was better.
I'm sorry. Hear me well. He was better than Yako Paper. But let's give him a bronze statue just yet.
Okay.
I'm just saying that there were some decisions that he made that were very interesting.
What else happened?
The red card was the red card. Let's deal with it. That was right. Like,
what is wrong with Scrum off?
Why are you trying to be hard?
What is wrong with Jaden?
No, everything's wrong with Jaden. Service delivery, it takes a year.
You know,
and then he's doing special things, thinking he's hard.
You walk into a place. You walk into a place, you look around. So now I know in this place I've got three cameras just on me.
Yeah.
Oh, Jaden, good camera, and you can see a camera.
There's the camera. Isn't that the camera?
He will find you. It doesn't matter what you do. Like, if you scratch your balls, he will find you.
Gents, do you know?
I was saying, there's this thing they have in New Zealand now, the player cam.
Yeah.
There's a player cam. So if you have whatever subscription they have on Sky,
yeah,
you can literally watch Zola the whole game. There's a camera that follows Zola the whole game. If Jaden gets that, swear he'll get probably sent off in every game, because he's always doing silly stuff. Like, why are you trying to elbow somebody? You've done everything right. You've held him up. You've taken him into touch. You've got the line out. You're in the opposition half. Everything's dope. Then you actually
swing elbows. You realize that should have been a red card and a yellow card, though. No. Because you're in the six, had him on the neck.
Right? No. That's a penalty.
No, red card.
No, it's a penalty.
I think he started holding him here. Yeah.
And then when the guy tried to drop down,
That's when he ended up
being it's not, it wasn't like a neck roll.
I think you guys.
Lunga said, do you realize that he could have gotten away when we were playing 2002 or whatever, right? In this day and age, you can never get away with anything dodgy, guys.
All I want to understand is why. And I think it's unfair to put a, how old is Jaden? 21, 22.
Yeah.
To put a 22-year-old on the spot like that is a touch unfair. Mm.
But you know what?
But the accountability needs to be there. Like, someone needs to ask him. And I feel like he needs to be asked in public. Like, what the hell are you doing?
For the next 12 years now.
Yeah, like, you're going to be that guy.
Yeah, like, geez, we could have taken
him. We had them.
If it wasn't for the red card, we could have.
We don't know what the result could have been.
Yeah.
But when the red card happened, we lost everything, right? Yeah. From 31, 38 to 70, 31. Like, you stuffed the team.
But everybody made that tackle. But no, the first.
But you stuffed the team.
Gents, all
it's
I'm saying
is. It's easy to make tackles when there's 15.
We could have. Not we. The Sharks. That was we.
I like South African. Come over to the black.
Okay, listen, all I'm saying is. It could have been a tighter game. For me, the score does not reflect the game.
Yeah.
Obviously, after that red card, everything just opened up. 15, you've got four nations playing a provincial team with 14 men.
So, guys, what do you think? What do you think about new rules? Do you think
Had they played, we actually asked the question, had they played, would it have changed the outcome?
Because it's 10 minutes or something. 20. It's
20, then you come back.
No, then someone else comes.
Yeah, someone else, yeah.
That wouldn't have changed anything.
No, it would have.
20 minutes. 45th minute.
When did we get ready?
It was early in the second, beginning of the second half.
Okay, okay.
No, I think it would have changed.
It would have been similar.
Look, we would have lost because they scored like, what, three or four tries?
19 minutes.
Because it was 11 tries to 5. They scored like 4 tries.
I think they won 71.
Would have been burnt either way, but I think...
I think the score would have been
50, not 70.
Probably.
Somewhere there, right? Or the Sharks could have made a run.
Yeah.
With 15 players, but I don't know. Yeah. But look, as a diehard Sharks fan, I'm proud of the guys for the way they showed up. Lionel Cronier showed you that experience is needed.
Yeah.
But he's kicking, he needs to get his kicking right.
He's still fine. He doesn't need to do anything.
No, but he missed a couple of easy kicks.
Bernard Cox, that's true.
Is Bernard Cox angry? What's happening in his life?
No. He says sorry after the game.
His effort.
But Sevens has made him a much better
player. So seeing as Zola's still standing on 3-0.
Yeah.
After watching the Lions play, what, 3 games now?
3-0.
Yeah.
Where you at, Leon?
2-1.
Are you back? Are you with me now?
No, I'm 2-1. 2-1
now?
Yeah, I'm 2-1. After
the COVID.
No. Yeah. There's going to be a game where we're going to probably lose. I think the first, I truly believe the first time we're going to win, and then we're going to have big hits, and then they come back second one because our boys are going to be, ooh, celebration. And then third game, we take it 2-1.
I'd rather go into the third game 2-0.
Listen here, I'll buy your case. 3-0.
Buy me a case of golden giraffe.
2-1.
3-0.
2-1. I say 2-1.
I'm on the fence now. I've been saying 2-1 all along.
You watched the first 20 minutes of the game.
Yeah. When
the Sharks were...
I don't know
how to defend. They can't handle the rush defense.
Peter Sam is going to get up and test you behind every game line for good 60 minutes.
Yeah. Lunga, when you guys were making your first time tackles, they couldn't handle
it. That's when those interceptions
started creeping in. Yes, they couldn't handle it. Yes, they couldn't handle it. But then when you missed the tackle, that's when they made it.
Because I'm looking at the teams that they put out, and I'm going, I still can't find their first team. Mm-hmm. I don't think they've played it yet.
Duhan van Der Merwe.
Guys, I've never heard such unnecessary hype in my life.
I think he's big for nothing, man. Hmm? He used to play at Ellis Park.
No.
He's not great.
All I'm saying is he's playing left wing, right?
Yeah.
So two things that van Der Merwe's equivocally unaware of, probably. Mm. One, Cheslin can't actually tackle.
Yep.
Right?
Yeah. The smallest guy will tackle.
And two,
he's got pace.
He's got unbelievable pace.
And skill.
And when he skins him one-on-one, I want to see that oil tanker. I want to see that oil tanker turn around and chase him.
No, he won't.
I want to see that.
105 kgs.
Nah, I'm going.
Like that. Nah. Like, I watched him yesterday.
As much as I don't rate English players in general, I think Johnny May is a better winger than Duhan van Der Merwe. Like, I don't understand what all this hype is about. And they left Johnny May at home. Johnny May is quick. He's solid under the high ball. He's basically a fullback with pace.
He's not South African.
So we had to bring somebody here for the news, right? I literally feel like Beckham did that. Because who else are we talking about in the team?
Duhan.
Nobody. He's the only guy we're talking about.
Yeah.
And he's going.
You know why? Because he's South African.
And he's going to try.
No,
he's but he's scoring. That 15 is scoring more tries than him, man.
Reese is scoring. Jones is scoring tries. Exactly.
The forwards are scoring tries, man.
That guy,
guys, he's all hype. I saw him yesterday.
Okay.
I don't know. Like the scrum hasn't showed me
anything. Versus him.
The scrum hasn't showed me.
Sit. And he's like, oh yeah, buddy. He's gonna make him sit.
I'm watching these guys and I'm going.
Guys, I'm not convinced.
Are we right to be concerned? Is the series going to be as big as what we want it to be? No. Of course, the allure is gone because like
there's no fans.
The stadium's empty.
There's no fans. There's
but
no
fans. I just don't know if the team is as strong as they're saying it.
No, they're not. Lunga, I've watched, I think, 3 or 4 games that they've played.
They played a bunch of kids yesterday. They played a bunch of kids who made immature decisions in the second half.
And the kids got them 26 all at halftime. That is four nations. Four nations versus a provincial team. No, I'm not
so hype, guys. Lawrence Andrianza still plays rugby. Lawrence Andrianza still plays rugby. I was like, come to the
team.
I was like, yeah. When you test the squad depth. you're gonna bring out the fossils.
Listen, come here, come here. But the fossil did the work with the lights.
No,
the fossil did it with the lights.
Look, if I'm Sean Everett, I'm on the plane to Durban today going, you know what?
I'm proud of these boys. I'm more proud of the guys who played yesterday than the one that played on Wednesday. I'm very proud of them.
Jade a good 15,000?
Fun is all salary.
Yeah,
just you lose your match with a 20
captain Medu Pedulani. Well done, very proud of you. That boy carried.
His workload, bro. He's underrated. His workload.
After these two games,
yeah,
I'm pretty sure that the people somewhere in Europe thinking about, you know what, he hasn't played for the box, you know?
Yeah, he's a junior box now. He's a junior box only.
So he plays for Wales for about 3 years, he's Welsh.
He's Welsh.
But guys, on a serious note, I want to ask you guys something. Should this tour still continue?
The answer to your question for me personally is it shouldn't, but it has to because of where we are now.
Yeah.
Guys, it has to for Springbok rugby though.
So tell us, we've got championship.
We need rugby.
But we can't stay in the hotel.
The problem is the buyer.
We can't stay in the hotel.
The system's working. I keep telling you the system is working.
I want to ask you guys something. Okay, should we not have it in one place? Like, say, Cape Town.
Let's go to Cape Town.
Let's go to Cape Town. Give it a bio bubble at Cape Town. Because Josie, clearly, these guys get excited about Namabo.
Here's your... You stay there.
Don't talk about farms.
It's nice then, Stellenbosch in Cape Town. So you can step on grapes. And you just come to Cape Town just for the game and go back.
The tour has to happen because we're here now. Three games in the tour.
To England to go play the last
one. I just think we have to play. I think Cape Town makes more sense.
Yeah.
Because clearly the Joburg bubble has not worked.
No.
That's the problem.
But I don't know, because for me personally, like we've been saying, these guys are getting paid to do something, right?
Yeah.
And now we're discussing the when you serve two masters, who's more important?
Hmm?
Because you know the Springboks are the one and your sponsors are the other. And Zola's got a point. Ugozi can get a car in Joburg. Why can't he get a car in Cape Town? So the sponsors are always going to be there.
But then, like, also again, I'm just worried about how easy it was to actually say, "But listen, you can come fetch your car and get closer to you." But do you know how many people that you were going to meet at the dealership?
Yeah, like
the whole dealership. On the way as well.
Yeah. Wouldn't have been too bad. I don't know. I think Cape Town probably makes more sense.
Yeah, let's do Cape Town.
So with regards to player accessibility, mm-hmm. how was it in terms of
the whole situation, everything was done before the lockdown.
Okay.
Before the cap? Before the 14, a month ago, before the 14 day period, before it started.
Before we went back to level 4.
So it was an easier time. It was an easier time for them.
But I think, look, it's an interesting point that which makes me think that maybe Cape Town is better. It doesn't really make a difference in terms of like the sponsors are still going to be there, right? But I don't know, is the accessibility going to be the same? Are we going to put this bubble under like level 4 type?
I'm pretty sure surely now they've learned their lesson now.
They have to.
Like,
started with smooth, then it came and then they have to.
Yeah, because now we like the jokes of...
Of world rugby.
Yeah, world rugby. But
yeah, because we said everything's going to be fine, was that?
Yeah.
Now, so,
and funny enough, guys, the British and Irish Lions haven't had a case, only the one case. We've had 12 plus players, like the whole team. So, what are we saying?
And the irony for me is we've seen more of the British and Irish Lions in action.
That's the other thing I was getting
in. Box, and here, these guys are actually all getting COVID.
Our vaccine is not working.
Oh, wait, what are the subsidies we buy? I see that. I don't want to laugh. But you're not giving me much to work with.
Anyway, I'm going to wrap up the bridges and ice line tour. So you boys think the tour still
should Look, it's too late.
I mean, the guys are here. And I think I heard something that the Springboks might play the Lions, Sigma Lions.
Wow.
Just for practice.
Talk about a practice game. That
for practice.
Why don't they play the Bulls?
I don't know.
I think they must play the Bulls.
Just if I remember correctly, okay, obviously 97, Nobin Posil, when they were here. When we used to have everybody playing for the Springboks, playing for the Unions.
And then they joined the Springboks later.
If you're not playing that weekend, you get dropped to go play for Union when they play against
the British and Irish Lions. Yeah.
Now it's not working because everybody's in Europe or Japan. So it makes sense
that in 97 they let the players go back to the Unions because remember 97 was a year into professionalism.
Yeah,
we didn't have that great a class on contracts. And
everybody is like, oh,
because no, but remember they were in New Zealand a few years ago, right?
They played
the Maori All Blacks, but all the All Blacks that were in the squad didn't play.
They didn't play out.
It's the same principle
Also again, I think if Blue Bulls played against them, Blue Bulls would have won.
Against who? I think so too. Let's move on to Curry Cup.
Show is over. I'm going home.
Wait, hold on. For the first time in how long?
90 years.
Let's talk about
you guys lost to Griquas at home. At home. What's going on? Griquas made my Friday.
I was mad because the Springboks weren't going to play.
But you know what? I'm loving it. You know, I said it.
Shout out to Scott Matthew, Albert van den Berg. Great work, coaching staff at Griquas. It was a great game.
I used to say that all these small teams, why are they there? Now they showed me why the small teams are there. So, like, you know, giant killers.
And Sue had a good game. He was doing things, he was kicking in the right direction.
Evan Ross even had a good game.
I think Evan Ross will be a Springbok.
Yep. He's very good.
Why am I talking to you now?
Do you know who his mentor is? Duhan van der Merwe.
I think Namakawa has a bright future. Yes. And Evan Rose will be a buck in the next year or maybe two, but I think sooner rather than later.
Evan Rose is something special. But your province.
Okay, let's talk about your favorite topic in the Curry Cup this weekend. Wingers with scrum caps.
Jeez. What's going on here, bro?
Daniel Cassendi, great game against Western Province. That was a good
Coach Rugga doesn't like it. Coach Rugga, what do you think? We're going to talk about it today, Coach Rugga.
No, I think it's that age where players are more conscious of safety and
but it's funny, it's the wingers though, not even the centers. I would have thought the centers would have been the backline players. What's also great about that?
You're not getting those wings who are 100 kgs anymore.
And these are small wingers.
Good enough. It doesn't matter if you're small. Yes. Just come in.
I love it.
Hey, I'm finding out where the man. Hey,
I think Cheslin led the way.
So Cheslin is the blueprint with the scrum.
Was it lazy from the shots?
No, it was Gio Aplon, actually. That's just
me. Gio was mentor to Cheslin.
iPhone 5, iPhone 8, the Power Rangers.
You know, someone said that Gio Aplon would have been Heineken Mayer's Cheslin.
Yeah, I've seen that.
You know, it's got to go 2005. He should have, 2015, actually, yeah. He should have put him on there to say, listen, I've got an original Cheslin. He was original stepper.
But he had the one that Lord chose in 2015. He didn't need Chachio.
Let's move on to the other game.
Greek was great game. In the Cheetahs Pumas game, the battle of the underrated Flyhawks. Oh, what a game. The Lions need Eddie Fischer back.
The Lions need everyone back, bro.
All I'm saying is I'm just going to make a personal statement. If Mornay Steyn and Francois Steyn can still get into the Springboks,
what?
Ruan Pina.
Come on. Yeah, had a great game.
Ruan turned back the clock.
Service delivered.
Unlike Jaden, the way to the moon to move.
Through the grapevine, the ball. There's beef with Ruan for missing a lot of kicks.
No, that's when he was wearing number 10.
How big is
that? Was Peter the Villiers going out? You'll play where you where I need to play.
So you reckon Ruan Pina should be per se?
Where's Kobe?
I'm just saying.
I don't know.
I think he almost won the man.
But he had a super game.
Brilliant game.
I'm just saying.
He even scored a try.
Yeah.
He outsprinted a fullback, man.
As you're saying, if Mone can come back,
we're not even sure if he's going to play. As he's staying is there, like, no, bring him back.
I've got a controversial question.
Leon and controversy. This is going to be interesting.
I want to ask you guys, do you think Currie Cup is relevant right now?
Absolutely.
The British and Irish Lions are.
Absolutely. Yes, it is.
Why?
They were the best games I watched this weekend.
So
for real, the best game I watched this weekend was yesterday.
No,
also Leon, you must remember outside the 45, there's still other players.
Yeah.
So with injuries, COVID.
Where do we pick from?
Not gonna go to under 20.
Emergency selection.
Emergency, and you must look at the shots. It's not like
I have 9 players in the 46. 9.
And
I had to turn out two teams in 3 days.
This team's not that great.
I had to turn out two teams in 3 days. You can hate all you want, but I gave you 30 players in 3 days, and I got 9 players missing.
What's nice also that these weekend games, these midweek games.
Coming back from work,
you're like,
I worked on Friday and scored. Okay, look, you're right.
You had a worst day because Providence lost again.
No, the Friday game made my weekend because I walked in on Friday and Providence lost.
So you had a worst weekend in your life.
I don't like midweek rugby, but it's got its place.
I miss Rugga.
Leon, seriously, but what Zola's saying makes perfect sense.
Yeah.
I don't generally agree with Zola, but he's right.
I agree with you, Zola.
Currie Cup is relevant. Currie Cup has to be relevant because it speaks to the depth of South African rugby.
Okay.
If the guys aren't playing, so just because, so once every 12 years must suspend the Currie Cup.
It's crazy enough that under 21s are not playing. And the 90s under 21s are not playing. That's crazy. That's suicide.
It's insane.
Yeah. So you're saying if, God forbid, our CR gets sick and he gets sick for more than four weeks, we could choose a six from there, or we could choose
a genre,
a fan type playing as such.
James Fenton, I'm a fan.
We can do things.
Genre Rudolph at the Cheetahs.
Okay.
Quality number 6 too.
Yeah, bro.
All right.
We have options, but if these guys aren't playing, where we see them?
I hear you. I wanted to pose that question because
look at our first rugby.
It's full of provincial players who were playing during the week.
Because we can't pick
the Lions were that great, we would have had the whole team.
They were not that great.
That's why we've got Currie Cup players playing there in our first 15. I'm sure if we can turn up that squad against Georgia or something, that same squad.
But I think this squad would club the Richmond Irish Lions as well.
This squad would club Georgia.
Guys, this squad would win by one point.
I'll coach it with Jacques.
Who's going to be the one of us? Who's going to be the one of us?
No, Russ is your coach.
He's the one of us.
But anyway, boys. Let's wrap it up. It's been a great show.
Yeah.
Upcoming games. I'm very excited. I think SA is playing this week.
No, Stormers first.
Is it Stormers first?
Stormers on Wednesday.
Stormers on Wednesday.
And then SA.
I want to watch
Sorry, Western Province. Western Province.
And you guys send back Magic back, isn't it?
Yeah.
To Stormers to help.
Yeah, because he had a great game against Georgia. For the box.
What is the SA game? It's the SA game on Saturday.
It's on Friday. It's on Friday.
I'm looking forward to that. I think that for me is going to be the blueprint to see it.
I'm curious to see who's in that team.
We know exactly who's going to
The squad is
we know exactly who's going to
squad is sick.
But I just want to see who they're going to pick against.
In the SAA,
It's going to be very interesting.
So we know exactly who they have.
I know. But we're going to know who's going to be their first team.
Yeah, the first team.
Our bench will be the starters in the first team.
Just come in and get those things when they walk the pop squad.
The pop squad.
Malcolm Box, spicy bro.
But I'm also going to be curious because...
Another knock-on.
Big scrum. Spicy plum comes this way.
After you've been scrumming.
Malcolm Box comes this way. It's beautiful.
You've been going backwards on skates for 55 minutes and then they bring spicy plum. But I'm curious because Catherine has to start now, slowly show his hand.
Yeah.
In that SAA game.
But he did against the first game against the Sharks.
Yeah. But just, I'm actually interested because the British and Irish Lions
Whichever starting back line is Bandy,
but you also need to keep them fresh. They need to be back fit because Okita Stefan Magdalena. 80 minutes. Dilaba.
Boys, I gotta wrap up the show. What are we drinking today again?
Golden Giraffe. We should also try the
Zola, where are we? 44 Queen Street.
Sorry, 44
Queen Street. 44 Queen Street, huh? New town. Guys,
tell them Zola sent you.
We appreciate the love. We see you guys, you know. Keep following us on YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook.
We appreciate all the comments.